The experiences of Andres Bonifacio in the 1890s and Crisanto Evangelista in the 1930s. He understood the revolutionary idea of the working class as the guide to continuing and accomplishing the Philippine Revolution. He became active in the People's Movement for National Liberation and Democracy in the late 1950s. In 1950, he organized the SCAUP, Student Cultural Association of the University of the Philippines, a progressive and patriotic organization of students. Then in 1961, he led the mass occupation of the lower house of Congress to protest the anti-communist sessions there. In most of the 1960s, he devoted himself to educational and organizational work among the youth, workers, and peasants. In 1964, he organized the Kabataan Makabayan, KM, Patriotic Youth, of which he was the founding chairman. He held leading positions in the Lapiang Manggagawa, later named Socialist Party, and in the United Front Organization Movement for the Advance of Nationalism. Together with 12 young revolutionary colleagues, he founded the Communist Party of the Philippines on December 26, 1968, under the guidance of Marxism, Leninism, Mao Zedong thought. A few years earlier, in 1967, he led the first great rectification movement by breaking off from the old Communist Party and exposing its revisionism and opportunism. He led the formation of the New People's Army on March 29, 1969, with only 9 automatic rifles and 26 inferior firearms against the US-backed Marcos dictatorship, the US-backed Marcos regime. He co-founded the National Democratic Front of the Philippines in 1973. Ka Joma's daring vision and trust in the masses have borne rich fruit. Despite massive attacks by the US Marcos regime and succeeding reactionary governments, the Communist Party of the Philippines has grown to 150,000 party members throughout the country. The New People's Army operates in more than 110 guerrilla fronts in 71 out of a total 81 provinces. Organs of democratic power, alternative people's governments based on revolutionary mass organizations of workers, peasants, women, youth, children, and cultural activists carry out land reform, health, education, and cultural programs. They organize people's militias and self-defense units of people's organizations which assist the People's Army. Even under prolonged torture, isolation, and imprisonment by the US Marcos dictatorship from November 1977 to March 1986, he continued to inspire the revolutionary masses. Posters such as, "You can imprison a revolutionary, but not the revolution," sprouted in many places with his image. He wrote poems and articles while in prison. After his release from prison during a world lecture tour in 1987, the Corazon Aquino regime canceled his passport to pressure him to return to the Philippines. He decided to apply for political asylum in the Netherlands. Despite 2 decisions of the highest administrative court the Rat van State, favoring officially recognizing him as a political refugee, the Dutch government has refused to grant him residence and his other rights.
Okay, Julie.
In 1992, he played a key role in the Communist Party's launching of the Second Great Rectification Movement. This was an educational movement to identify, repudiate, and rectify errors of a group of renegades within the party leadership, which had caused major losses. Again, with characteristic daring, he exposed the main perpetrators, beaming the light on them while they made their attacks from the darkness. This rectification movement was embraced by the overwhelming majority of the members of the party, the People's Army, and the revolutionary masses. This rectification movement has resulted in the reinvigoration of the revolutionary movement with the recovery of lost mass base and its further expansion and consolidation. While abroad, Ka Joma has been participating in conferences, seminars, and other activities of revolutionary parties, organizations, and mass movements in order to promote and develop the solidarity of the Filipino people with the peoples of the world. In 1999, he led the initiative committee in preparing the founding of the International League of People's Struggle, ILPS, in 2001. He is now the chairperson of the ILPS, which has held 4 international assemblies and has more than 300 member organizations in more than 40 countries. The ILPS is now a major force in the anti-imperialist and democratic movement of the people of the world. Upon being put on the terrorist list in 2002 by the US, the European Union, and other foreign governments, Ka Joma initiated a legal battle to get his name out of the EU terrorist list. With the help of outstanding lawyers led by Jan Vermon of Belgium and assisted by other capable lawyers from the Philippines, Germany, France, and the Netherlands, he won the 7-year legal battle. In December 2009, the Council of the European Union, upon orders of the European Court of Justice, took his name off the EU terrorist list. In 2007, he again fought a successful legal battle against trumped-up charges of murder filed by the Arroyo regime in the Philippines in collusion with the US and Dutch governments. Imprisoned in isolation in The Hague for 17 days, his brilliant lawyer, Michiel Pesman of Amsterdam, ably assisted by attorney Romeo Capulong of the Public Interest Law Center in the Philippines, they won the case after a year and a half. A tireless fighter, Ka Joma continues to fight for his rights. A week ago, the Rat van State issued a negative decision denying his right to residence and a passport. He and his lawyers insist that a European law of 2004 entitles him as a recognized political refugee to residence and a passport. He and his lawyers are considering further legal steps to assert his rights. Despite all the harassments, he continues to be politically active. Through so many years, Ka Joma has guided the National Democratic Front of the Philippines negotiating panel in the peace negotiations with the government of the Republic of the Philippines. He has played a key role in the forging of such peace agreements as the Hague Joint Declaration, the Framework Agreement of 1992, the Joint Agreement on Safety and Immunity Guarantees of 1995, and the Comprehensive Agreement on Respect for Human Rights and International Humanitarian Law of 1998. He has also been the moving force in the CPP and NDFP Declaration of Adherence to the Geneva Conventions and Protocol 1, in the twists and turns of the peace negotiations with the reactionary Philippine government, Ka Joma has upheld the equal footing of the NDFP and the independence and revolutionary integrity of the People's Democratic Government. Ka Joma, as was shown in the Red Salute and also books that are available there, is also a writer and poet. The documents he authored, the poems and songs he wrote, the revolutionary struggle he launched, and his sense of humor, these are all part of his rich revolutionary legacy to the Filipino people. Mabuhay si Ka Joma. Long live Ka Joma. His daring and vision and his trust in and reliance on the masses. Thank you.